This concert is actually a collaboration between the NUS Symphony Orchestra and the NUS Choir. And it's actually the first time in a long while NUS had its choir and orchestra put together in a concert.
And performing this big piece, the Beethoven Ninth Symphony, which is actually the first example of a symphony that uses voices, and it's often termed the choral symphony. After the past few practices with the orchestra itself, we get to hear how the orchestra do the piece, and then the orchestra get to hear how the chorus do the singing. And when getting up together, it's a very warm and very grand kind of atmosphere.
The idea of unity that Beethoven brings, uniting not just the alumni, the choir, different members from different faculties and backgrounds coming together, playing this single piece, which is really meaningful. And so expect a spectacle, but also delve into deeper meanings behind it, which is more towards unity and also the freedom of us expressing ourselves as well. One thing that excites me the most about this concert is definitely the idea of performing a whole symphony. You know, as a musician myself, I've never had that chance before, and I think many of our members had not had that chance before as well, to perform a full symphony, which that's something usually only professional orchestras would tackle. And yeah, it's kind of the first time also is tackling such a huge piece.
The past few months was actually quite hectic. We actually just came back from Wales after the Beethoven World competition, and we quickly transitioned into the practices for this upcoming Beethoven Ninth concert. With the new members coming in, which includes the public singers, the practices are quite smooth, even though the piece is actually quite demanding. But our members are actually quite devoted and dedicated into performing the piece well. I hope what we can offer you is that you actually sense the joy, sense the exuberance of passion through our singing itself. So yeah, we hope you enjoy it.